I got the X-Knight 360 last year for doing some invisible drone shots. I installed a Crossfire Nano receiver into it, and I have been getting really bad range on this quad. One reason for the bad range is likely that the Crossfire antenna is mounted partly inside the frame, right up against the carbon fiber bottom plate. However, this being an invisible drone does limit the antenna mounting options quite a lot. So I decided to swap out the Crossfire Nano for the amazingly small ExpressLRS EL24E receiver with the built-in ceramic antenna. I set both the Crossfire and the ExpressLRS TX modules to 250 milliwatts and fixed to 150 Hz. The difference is, of course, that the Crossfire is on 868 MHz, while the ExpressLRS is on 2.4 GHz. Let's do a direct comparison. I am standing in front of my garage, at the red dot. The blue dot is the position of the drone. I'm facing the wrong way and flying behind me on purpose in these tests. The Crossfire link quality dropped down to 43 here, when the quad is directly behind me, only 80 meters away. The ExpressLRS, on the other hand, is still at 99% link quality. I'm now coming around and flying over to the other side. Just trying to sync up the DVR of the two flights here. The Crossfire LQ is dropping down to 70 here when on the other side of the house. This is not really a fair test, since there is clearly an issue with the Crossfire receiver or antenna on this drone. This here is where the ExpressLRS showed its lowest LQ of the entire flight, 88%. However, it is clear that the tiny Flywoo EL24E receiver with its built-in ceramic antenna is working very well. Much better than I expected it to, in fact. This is where I got a micro failsafe with the Crossfire receiver when the LQ suddenly dropped down to 30. I did not originally plan to swap my Crossfire receivers over to ExpressLRS, but based on these results, I might consider doing just that, even if this wasn't a completely fair comparison.